Let's look at a different combination. Okay, this is a combination done with the subtraction operation. Okay, so again, this combination function f minus g of x, we can create this by taking f of x and subtracting g of x. Okay, so we replace, and I'm going to write this out again, we have f minus g of x. We replace f of x with the variable expression for f of x minus, and then we put g of x. In a previous video for addition, right, we did this problem. We talked about how important it was to have these parentheses, right? Especially in this case where we're subtracting a binomial. What this means is, and we need these parentheses because this is telling us we have to subtract every term that's in g of x. So really we're distributing this negative sign, if you will, to the x, and we're distributing this negative sign to the negative 3. So when I go to start simplifying this, again, I have nothing here that I need to distribute. I have no exponent. I have nothing from the back that I'm going to distribute. So the parentheses here kind of just fall away, all right? But over here, we have minus x and a minus negative 3. Subtracting a negative 3 is the same thing as addition. You wouldn't see that if you didn't put these parentheses, right? If you just wrote this minus x minus 3 like that, and you just put that in for g of x without the parentheses, you notice this would be wrong. This has to be a positive 3 because we're subtracting all of those terms. The rule of thumb is, and this is what I say in my classes all the time, parentheses are like life jackets, okay? You've ever been on a boat, there's a bunch of life jackets there, right? And what the rule of thumb is, it's better to have them and not need them than to need them and not have them. Think about a life jacket. It's better to be on a boat and look at a dusty old life vest and be like, well, at least it's there, right? Have them there just in case, right? Than if you're on a sinking ship and you're like, where are all the life jackets? So that's, parentheses are the same thing. Treat them that way. Put them in anytime you do a substitution. You don't know if you're going to need them. I didn't need them here, so I just dropped them. I did need them here because I needed to be reminded that I'm subtracting all these terms. Then when we go to combine like terms, we've got 2x squared minus negative 5x minus x is negative 6x, and 4 plus 3 is positive 7. So this is our new function f minus g of x created by subtracting those two functions. Okay?